Erizoba kijana spokesman witu nishaba tumwe kita chikemwe to just greet us and our atmosphere.
Rama Simwe. Asimwe mnonga ruhanga. Abanyamyanja abanyakunjiri mjurize gaya. Mujye tumwine shoga. Ashimwe shoga mkastahila njiye baheza anje.
Thank our elders, Reverend, and all the leadership of the church, our fellow leaders, you ladies and gentlemen, for inviting us to this auspicious occasion. I'm very, very honored. I want to thank you more especially because it is not very easy for anybody to associate with us for a very long time. I don't know, should I continue speaking English? Thank you very much. Ngabukana. Ni za kuimi singa. Okay. So it is not so easy to invite us, so I want to thank you, comrades, for following your heart and inviting us. I am here as a son of this place. In spirit, but also in blood. In spirit, I am a Catholic, but my mother was an Anglican. I repeat, my father was a Catholic, but my mother was an Anglican. Even though I was a Catholic, I was very, very close to my mother. I was number six among my mother's children, but they used to call my mother Mama Robert because I was her favorite child. She looked just like me, so now you know my mother was very beautiful. So, since I was a young boy, I used to go with my mother to the Anglican church, place where I met people like the late Byabakama Charlesn, and my mother used to sing in choir. And that is where I developed my musical talent from. And as if that was not enough, when God offered me a wife, He offered me the best from the West. And my wife is also an Anglican. So this union, this relationship, I believe many times it was made in heaven. And as if that was not enough, when God chose a wife for me, He did not choose from Uganda. He did not choose from anywhere. He chose from Western Uganda. That shows us that God had a plan, not just for me, not just for Bobby, but for our generation. God had a plan for us. So today, so many years later, it reminds us that the divisions that we had in the past regarding religion, the divisions we had in the past regarding tribe and all those other things are things of the past indeed. This generation is the generation of Ugandans living as one. And as the preacher said, we must continue living as one Uganda and yes, as one people. Loving each other, respecting each other, and looking out for the best in and for each other. And that is what we celebrate. Right now, as young leaders of this generation, we try to learn as much as possible from each other, but also teach each other what we learn. We primarily learn from our elders, and it is important that we keep the best from our elders, but also learn from each other because we have new experiences as a generation. To learn to live together, to learn to exalt the good things that we learn from our elders. And yes, we are the generation to correct those mistakes that were made historically. So as we come here to pray together, as we come here to congregate together, may we all be reminded that we are children of Uganda. And this country, what it will be in 50 years, it is being decided now. We all know that we live in a deeply divided country, and it should not be like that. We live in a deeply hateful country, and it must not be like that. Our parents and grandparents played their part. It is upon us as the new generation to unite our country and to choose what is best for our country. We want our young daughters and sons to be holding hands, not caring what tribe they come from, not caring what political party they come from, not caring what religion they come from, but all standing proudly and saying we are children belonging to the power of Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, that is not going to happen by mistake. That is going to happen by what we do. Because what this country is going to be in 5, 10 or 20 years from now is being decided today by us. It will be our dream to see those little boys and girls standing up as men and women with the foundation of love, with the foundation of unity, but most importantly, with the foundation of respect for each other. And that we can only do it not through our words, but through our actions. So as we walk to the election in 2021, no matter what political party you come from, no matter what tribe you come from, we should put our country before ourselves. We should be one person, and as the preacher said, yes, appreciate the concept of one Uganda, one people. But all this, we do it for the people that we lead, because we are servants of those people. We as leaders, we believe in people power, that we are servants of the people. And we believe that people power is stronger than people in power. I thank you for the invitation, and I look forward for the entertainment. Banshawa mbungambo Uganda, nesimanyo kwa Uganda mbumanyi. Nevana nisanyo senyo waramba angewe na ukubela na mweze ni mwana wawano wadivanza la Uganda, na ye half of me is in Uganda and half of me is here, because this is where I got my best friend wano. We na wasa mchala wange, nize na wasa mwala waka gaju, kubaita pabla itungo, wawa nutunga mo. Sinze na chikende ni na naika tonda ya chikola, kuwanga ya liaga la tuyo na ikinge, nga generation. So, echo tuchukose se, nebila la vingi nyo, tumanye tukuli mtuomu, tuina kwa gana na.